Thank you, Chris, for coming on the Eleanor Jang show. I just made that up.
Yeah.
A lot of people in Taiwan, they have no idea what to do when they get in college. So they start to think, should I quit school?
Okay. Whether or not you should quit school really largely depends on whether or not you're getting what it is that you're supposed to get out from school. So a lot of people assume you go to school, you're going to learn something very valuable, you're going to have very employable skills when you get out into the marketplace. And I can't talk about going to school or dropping out of school unless we start talking about the finances, the economics of going to school. What does it cost for you to be in school, and what do you hope to get out of it? But if it's expensive to be here in school, you have to start to question, what value am I getting? So every transaction is made because there's a value exchange. I give you money, you give me knowledge and experience and network and contacts. So if those things aren't being held up by the school, then you have to start thinking about whether or not you want to be in school.
All right, so what are the three things that you need to learn in school?
If you're watching this video right now, take out a piece of paper and just put some thought into this. What are the three things that you want to get out of school? Like when you're done with school in 4 or 5 years, what do you hope to attain? And what's the most valuable? The first one is how to do public speaking. And why is that important to us? Because most leaders, most managers, most people that are inspiring the world to make change have the ability to speak to them in very direct ways. So public speaking is a very important skill in the 21st century. Number two is learning how to learn. In theory, the world is changing really quickly. In fact, everything that you're learning in school is already outdated by the time you learned it. By the time they codify it into textbook, it's already ancient history. Things that are happening in such a fast pace that we can barely keep up with what's going on, even as active working professionals. Forget about in the realm of academia, they're going to be so far behind. So the single most greatest skill that you're going to learn in school is learning how to learn. Learning how to formulate questions in your mind is probably the most important skill that you're going to need to survive in the next 100 years. And the last one is what we would loosely describe as logic and reasoning. All this stuff is not going to be any good for you if you can't be able to structure cohesive thoughts together and be able to, they mean to you on a core level, on a philosophical level, on an emotional level, then to be able to have a rational discussion or debate with somebody else about your thinking as a form of investigation and curiosity.
Okay, thank you. Another question that I get a lot is, Eleanor, I want to quit school, but I don't know how to convince my parents. So if today your son, he's in college and he says, Dad, I don't want to do this anymore. I want to quit school. How am I supposed to convince you so that you let me quit school and pursue what I want to do?
Why does it matter to you what your parents want you to do? That's the biggest thing. Is it because you depend on them financially to pay for school? Is it because there's some other reason, meaning like you don't do anything without their approval? And maybe that's a problem that begins this whole conversation.
So Chris actually gave a very good convincing point, is why does it matter? I know that in the Taiwanese culture, it does matter. My personal example is I gave my parents a brief. Like I gave them a proposal of what I will do in the next year or so and how I'll actually support myself financially. And I think I'm not a parent, but I guess if I am, I'll be like a business owner. I'm an investor, so my kid is my investment. So when they tell me this is what they want to do, I will want something in return. And I guess as a parent, the return is, I want you to be healthy. I want you to be happy. I guess if you do want to like convince your parents, give them a proposal. Give them a plan, because investors, they want plan. They want to know what's going to happen.
I like your approach to that very much. And I think looking at your parents like investors, stakeholders in your future, I think that's a good way to do it. But you also have to realize to them, and what you might do is you might make a case study of the three most well-known successful people out in the world and do it like a short biography on them to show your parents that most likely those people did not follow the conventional path. Elon Musk, Mark Zuckerberg, Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, none of these guys followed the traditional path because they went to school for a little bit and they all dropped out. Not Elon Musk, but they all dropped out.
You forgot to say another person.
Who's that?
Eleanor Jang. You're a business owner, so you hire people, you hire creatives. Whether or not if they're a dropout or a newly graduate, what skills do you look in them? Because some people who are watching this, they might have dropped out already. Most of them are still in school. So what's like a general skill that you look for, or personality?
Okay, so first of all, what I don't look for is your resume. I don't look for what school you went to, what degree you got, or even if you went to school at all. None of that matters to me. Typically speaking, when we're looking to hire people, either on a freelance or permanent basis, we're looking at the quality of the work that you do. And we're willing to overlook some shortcomings if you make up for it in your personality and your attitude. So let's talk about the things that you can actually change and demonstrate outside of your portfolio. If we see that you're really determined, ambitious, driven, if you're a self-learner, if you're a good communicator, if you play well with others, those things matter a lot to us. What we want to do is figure out what is your maximum potential with us. If we feel like the ceiling is quite high, we may make the investment in our time and energy and resources to help you get there. And that's where we can actually make money together.
Another question that I get asked a lot is, I'm in college, I got pushed into a program or degree that I never liked, but I don't know what I like either. How am I supposed to find my passion?
So when nobody's watching, when nobody cares, what do you do in your free time? Are you reading comic books? Are you playing video games? Are you writing, drawing ideas? Are you always running around with your camera shooting and capturing things? What is it that you're doing? So I would start looking at the things that you do in your free time. If you don't know what that is, look into your past. Look at when you were 6 years old, 7 years old. Ask your mom, dad, what did I love to do when I was a kid? Can you tell me? And they're going to tell you something that was your natural instinct. This is what you love to do.
Thank you very much, Chris, for letting me pick your brain.